In the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. Look upon Mother Hinkle, Lord Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. Grant my help, the Lord, in the name of Jesus. Like God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord. Look upon them, Lord, as they travel over the highways and byways, Lord. In the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for your disciples, Lord, that is present in your sanctuary, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, look upon them, Lord, one by one, Lord Jesus, person by person, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to bring in the Lord God, your saints, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to increase, Lord, your saints in the sanctuary, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We need your prayer warriors, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord, to rain down your latter rain, Lord, upon your peoples, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon the sick and the shut-in everywhere, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, touch their body, Lord. Would you heal and save it and keep it virtual, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon, Lord Jesus, those, Lord, that has a prayer request, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to touch your saints, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, move in a mighty way, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord Jesus. We come and thank you, Lord Jesus, thank you, Lord. Like God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord Jesus, for being able, Lord, to give you the praise, Lord Jesus. Like God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we thank you, Lord Jesus, for your praise team, Lord, choir team combined together, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Like God of hosts, Lord, we thank you, Lord Jesus, for looking upon the neighborhoods everywhere, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Like God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon, Lord Jesus, the mothers and fathers, Lord, sons and daughters, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, look upon the schools, Lord, the colleges, Lord, down through preschool, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon, Lord, those, Lord, that's being homeschooled, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We need you, Lord Jesus, we need you, Lord, all day long, Lord Jesus, we need you. In the midnight hour, Lord, we need you, like God of hosts, Lord. We need you, Lord Jesus, when we bow down and pray, Lord Jesus. We need you, Lord Jesus, when you sing your praises, Lord. We need you, Lord Jesus, when we preach your word, Lord. We need you, Lord Jesus, when we teach your word, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, look upon us today, Lord, and have your way, Lord, and let your will be done, Lord. Not by our deaths, Lord, but your will be done according to your will, your way, your grace, and your mercy, Lord. We ask you, Lord, take charge of the service today, Lord. Lead us and guide us in the right direction, Lord. According to your will, your way, your grace, and your mercy, Lord. Anoint the speaker and the teacher today, Lord. In the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord. We thank you right now, Lord. We give you the praise, the honor, and the glory, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for your presence, Lord. In the name of Jesus, these blessings and others, we ask in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. This time we're going to turn you over to the praise team. Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
God's good.
All the time. All the time he's good. Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
We're going to sing this song again, and we just want to have you guys go around and shake somebody's hand and say, God is good. All right?
All right.
I'm Studies. On Thursday night, we also have topical study for Bible study with Pastor Tim. And our Wednesday Bible study is no longer. We moved it to Thursday night. And Saturdays, we have Torah teaching with Paul Schlimbo. And if you're interested in that, call Pastor Tim, because Paul's not always able to make it because of his job with the bees, or his business rather with the bees. And so Pastor Tim always knows if he's coming or not, so you have to check with him if you're interested in coming to that on Saturdays. One special thing. We have a tea on the 2nd of June. That's a week from this coming Saturday. And Barbara is spearheading for us to know. She needs to know who all wants to go. It's $5, ladies. It is a ladies' tea. Guys, you're not invited. Sorry, not this time. So, it's $5 for the tea. It's in Loomis. We're going to be carpooling. We're going to leave from here. So if you're interested in doing that and going with us, call Barbara Young and connect with her, because she's spearheading to make sure everybody gets a ride. We're going to carpool out of here at the church. Amen? And that's on June 2nd, and $5. It's in Loomis, so we have to leave a little early. Okay? And then... Pastor has contacted us for a prayer request. His brother David, okay? David's brother-in-law is going for surgery, and so we want everybody to pray for him. Okay, and that's today, correct?
His name is Chris.
And his name is Chris.
He's having surgery Friday.
Okay, he's having surgery Friday. I stand corrected.
And he wants Pastor Johnny to pray for all this prayer requests.
Okay, and then we'll have Pastor Johnny pray for all the prayer requests. And if you guys see empty seats in there, other than our pastor, who we know is on a trip with Fonda and Grandma, if there's any other people, and Barbara and so we're on a had to go elsewhere today. But other than them, if you see empty seats, pray for these people that haven't made it this week. Okay? And same prayer request as last week. They're on the back of last week's bulletin. We don't have a bulletin today. Amen? Or if God brings somebody to your mind, pray for them. Amen? So pray for Chris, David's brother-in-law, for his surgery on Friday. And pray for those that need the prayer. Amen? And keep our pastors covered in prayer, please. That's, you know, we should always pray for our leaders, not just the president, but our leaders here in the church, too. Amen? All right, and have a blessed week. And again, if you want to go to the tea, contact Barbara Young. Thank you, and have a blessed week, everybody.
Praise God, praise God. And this time we're going to do the prayer request. And so if any of you guys that feel the prayer, stand and pray along with me, because God can work in mysterious ways. And He works even faster and greater with the prayer warriors than He do. What's going on? Lord God of grace, Lord Jesus, we come before you, Lord. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, for those, Lord Jesus, that needs prayer, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord. Look upon Christ, Lord Jesus, his body, Lord, from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet, Lord. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord, to look upon the doctors, Lord Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, that's going to do surgery upon his body, Lord. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, you know the problems and the situations of his body right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord. We know, Lord Jesus, that you're the doctor of all doctors, Lord. Healer of all healers, Lord Jesus. Surgeon of all surgeons, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to rain down your latter rain, Lord Jesus, upon his body right now, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord, look upon the pastor, Lord Jesus, and brothers, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to come with the more, Lord Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we need you, Lord, more than ever, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord Jesus, look upon Chris, Lord Jesus, his family also, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, you know the situation and the problem of this body, Lord Jesus. We ask you, Lord, take charge, Lord. Have your way, Lord Jesus. Heal his body, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we request, Lord Jesus, that you touch and heal, Lord. You touch and save, Lord. In the name of Jesus, Lord God of hosts, Lord, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon, Lord Jesus, those, Lord, that is in the choir prayer request, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord, you have the power over all things, Lord Jesus. Through you and by you, Lord Jesus, all things is possible, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord, we know, Lord Jesus, that you can do all things, Lord Jesus, through you and by you, Lord Jesus. We thank you right now, Lord. We praise you right now, Lord Jesus. We claim, Lord Jesus, the healing, Lord Jesus. Claim to believe it right now, Lord, in the name of Jesus, and receive it, Lord, in your name, Lord Jesus. These blessings and others, we ask in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah.
As we sing again, this is the air I breathe. So go ahead and sing along with us and meditate on the Spirit as you make his, as you work in our hearts this morning.
Without you, Holy Spirit. So we give you all the praise and all the glory and all the honor. Thank you.
for the offerings and tithes, Lord Jesus, that to draw forth, Lord, in the name of Jesus, like God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord Jesus, bless and anoint those that gave, Lord Jesus, those that had a desire to give, Lord. These blessings and others we ask in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Okay.
No.
No,
oh,
forgot that.
You want me to do that?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Now so, take
that.
Well, that's okay. I'm versatile. Amen. Week of May 20th, 2018 to May 26th, 2018. Torah, Numbers 421 to Numbers 789, Prophets, Judges 13, 2 through 5, and Gospel, Luke 1, 11 through 20. The priestly blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance on you and give you peace. We've all heard that from Pastor Emily. Number 6 closes with the immortal words of the priestly blessing. A commandment for the sons of Aaron to bless Israel. To this day, the sons of Aaron lift their hands over the worshipers in the synagogue service while they utter the words. The Lord, next page, bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance on you and give you peace. That's number 6, 24 to 26. The three lines of the priestly benediction each invoke a different aspect of God's blessing. The first requests God to bless and keep us. Messiah has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Messiah. How many of you guys want to receive that one?
Yeah.
Amen? Ephesians 1:3. Through Messiah, the blessing of Abraham has come upon the Gentiles, and we all experience the fullness of the blessing of Messiah. Romans 15:29. Through Yeshua, God is able to keep you from stumbling and to make you stand in the presence of his glory. June 24, 2025. The second verse of the blessing says, the Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. Number 6:25. The shining of the Lord's face represents his attention and pleasure. His graciousness is the expression of his grace. Messiah is the fulfillment of this request as well. The gift of God's grace comes through the redemption which is in Messiah Yeshua. Romans 8:3-24. We believe that we are saved through the grace of the Master Yeshua, Acts 15:11, which God freely bestowed on us in the Beloved, according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished on us, Ephesians 1:6-8. The third verse of the blessing says, the Lord lift up his countenance on you and give you peace, Numbers 6:26. The lifting up of the Lord's countenance upon a person implies the smile of God. Messiah fulfills the request for peace. We have peace with God through our Lord Yeshua the Messiah, Romans 5:11. He told his disciples, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you. Do not let your heart be troubled, nor let it be fearful. John 14:27. Let the peace of the Messiah rule in your hearts, Colossians 3:15. And the peace of God, which surpasses all comprehension, will guard your hearts and your minds in the Messiah Yeshua, Philippians 4:7. This peace will cover the whole earth in the Messianic era. There will be no end to the increase of his government or of peace on the throne of David and over his kingdom to establish it and to uphold it with justice and righteousness from then on and forevermore. Isaiah 9:7. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Topic for today, the coming birth of Jesus Christ, Mary is foretold. Praise God. All right. Brother James is going to do the reading for
me.
1:26-27. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary.
Alright, praise God.
Matthew 1:18. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. When his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Matthew 2:4. And when he gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born.
Mm-hmm.
Matthew 2:5. And they said unto him, in Bethlehem of Judea, for thus is it is written by the prophet. Luke 1:28. And the angel came in unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women.
Praise the Lord.
Daniel 9:3. And I set my face unto the Lord God to seek by prayer and supplications with fasting and sackcloth and ashes.
Mm-hmm.
Daniel 10:9. Yet I heard the voice of his words, and when I heard the voice of his words, I was in a deep sleep on my face, and my face toward the ground.
Right.
Luke 1:29-31. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. Matthew 1:22. Now all this was done, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Now we know that when before Jesus was born, Mary was a virgin, never been touched by any man. And God sent his power, his anointing, and his grace, and Jesus was conceived in her womb. And he said to call his name Jesus. Elijah means Jesus. So we know God does everything, and he does it right. And if it wasn't for the Lord God of hosts, we wouldn't have the opportunity to call upon the name Jesus Christ, our Lord. He came down through 42 generations to save our sin-sick souls, that we might have the right to the tree of life, that we might be able to walk and talk and tell somebody about Jesus. Because we are his disciples, we are his forerunners.
Yeah, come on.
And by us being his forerunners, we have to make sure that we have Christ in our life. And we have to make sure that we walk according to his will and his way. And we have to make sure that when we are talking to somebody, that we are telling them what God told us to tell them. To give them the word that God gave us to give unto them. regardless of the place of the situation or the problem that they may be going through, if God give you a word to give unto them, give it to them. Because through us and by us, we are the walking, talking, living church. With this, we call, a lot of people call the sanctuary the church, but the sanctuary is where we all gather together to give God the praise, the honor, and the glory, to come and magnify his name, because he's worthy to be praised, worthy to be glorified, worthy to be lifted up. And through him and by him, all things is possible through the Lord. That's the reason why we call upon him for the healing of our bodies, our minds, our hearts, and our souls. Because without him, we can't make it. And if we try to make it without him, big mistake. Because through Jesus, God Almighty, we can talk, walk with him, talk with him. And if we are on your job, and you can't pray out loud, you can always secretly pray unto the Lord.
Yes, amen.
Because when you talk to him, he hears and he understands everything.
Amen.
He knows your mind before you know your mind.
Yes, amen.
He knows what you're going to say before you say it. He knows what you're going to do before you do it. So that's the reason why we have to stay in touch with the Lord.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
We have to call on him early in the morning, in the midday, late in the evening, in the midnight hours. We have to call on the Lord. And a lot of times we think the Lord ain't with us. He's in front of us. He's on the right side, left side, and he's behind us. So we can always depend on him.
Yes,
amen. Because he's always present.
Come on, brother, tell me.
Because with him, through him, all things is possible.
Yes, amen.
We think sometimes that we can't walk. And if we trust in God, we can. We think sometimes that we can't talk. But if we trust in God, we can. All things is possible with God.
Yes, amen.
Because he is the beginning and the ending, yes, the first and the last. He's the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. He's Alpha and Omega, beginning and the ending, the first and the last.
Yes, amen.
And when we depend on him, we know everything, yes, is going to be all right.
Thank you, Lord.
When you go to pray for somebody,
come on,
make sure you talk to the Lord before you do something.
Yes, amen.
And especially laying hands upon people, God is in control. That's the reason why said, anoint you with oil before you touch. Yes. Anoint yourself with oil before you touch. Because what's there is there. God can move it.
Yes.
But you have to have the power of the Lord. You have to have the power to pray right.
Amen.
You have to have the power to sing right. You have to have the power to walk right. You have to have the power of God to talk right. You have to have the power of God to do everything right according to his will and his way. Because if you don't have God's power upon you to lead you and guide you in the right direction, something's wrong somewhere along the line. That's the reason why you have an altar. You go to the altar, you bow down before him. You turn everything over unto the Lord, and you leave it there. Some of us got to have it. We'll put it on the altar and take it back. But what good does it do? Not at all. Because when you lay it on the altar, you give it to God.
Uh-huh.
You leave it there.
and let God handle it.
Come on.
Because when you try to handle it, it messes up worse than what it was.
Amen.
And then you wonder why God hadn't answered your prayer and his answer to you. You put it there, you took it back. Now it's going to take me longer to work it out. Because you done what you weren't supposed to do. Yeah. When you turn everything over to the Lord, turn it over to him. Leave it there. Leave it on the altar.
Yeah.
And if you're at home in your closet praying, you leave what you're talking to the Lord about in that closet, and God's going to work it out.
Come on.
Because he has all things in his hands. And that's the reason why we have to trust in him all day long.
Yes, amen.
All night long. Because he's going to be there when ain't nobody else is going to be there.
Yes,
that's the reason why.
Woo.
He went to the Virgin.
Yes, amen.
To conceive Jesus Christ in her womb. That we might have the light, the right to the tree of life. God sent his son down through 42 generations.
Yes.
To live and to die for us. For our sins. The whole wide world sins. That we might have the right to the tree of life. But if we don't trust in him, don't believe in him, something's wrong. That's the reason why we have to walk with the Lord all day long. We have to believe in him.
Come on.
All day long. We have to believe in him when we get ready to go to bed. We talk to him and says, Lord, wake us up early in the morning. Start us on our way. Because if these guardian angels don't watch over us all day long,
woo,
and all night long, and then he touches us with the finger of love, wake us up early in the morning.
Amen.
And start us on our way. And you think about so many woke up this morning and couldn't get up. And some didn't wake up at all. But God gave us the wisdom, knowledge, and the power and the strength to rise again and give him the praise, the honor, and the glory.
Woo.
Might be crippled in the body, but still give God the praise.
Yes, amen.
He gave you the strength to move. Move forward for the Lord. Because he is the healer of all healers.
Yes, he is.
He can heal your body when can't nobody else do it.
Yes, amen.
When the doctor say he done all he can do, God does the rest.
Amen.
Because he has all power to do everything that can be done and will be done.
Yes,
amen. All through him. All things is possible. That's the reason why we have to depend on him. We don't know the day, not the hour, not the minute, not the second that God is coming. But be prepared.
Yeah.
When he comes.
Yes, amen.
Might come early in the morning. Late in the evening.
Yeah.
We don't know. But I've heard the old song singing. I want to go home on the morning train because the evening train may be too late.
Yes, amen.
And we don't ever know when that hour is going to come. But depend on the Lord. Trust in him.
Yes.
Turn everything over to him. He has the power over all things. And without him, we wouldn't be able to make it.
Yes, amen.
And through him, all things is possible.
Come on.
And if you really think about it, the automobile you have, God gave it to you. The clothes you have, God put that on your back. Shoes you got, God put them on your feet. The house you live in, God provided that also.
Yes, amen.
The job you have, God provided that also. Everything you have, God provides.
Yes.
The food that goes in your stomach, God provided that.
Thank you, Lord.
And we have to remember, everything comes from the Lord. Not part of it, not half of it, all of it comes from Him. And what we do it for the Lord. Don't forget that we are the soldiers in the army of the Lord.
Yes, amen. Come on.
And the psalm says, I'm in the army of the Lord, and I promised Him that I would serve Him until I die. And if you're in the army of the Lord, keep on working.
Amen.
Keep on giving Him the praise.
Amen.
Because He's worthy of all the praise.
Yes, He is.
Sometimes we raise our kids up in church, and they know the rules and regulations of God. But rather than to follow the rules and regulations of God, they want to run around out in the world and do what the world wants them to do. And then when they get in trouble, the first thing they holler, oh Lord, why this and why that? You knew about me before you went there. But when we walk out into the world, a lot of people think the Lord left us. No, He didn't leave us, we left Him. And that's the reason why, when things go bad, the first thing we holler, oh Lord. But if you're out there, come back unto the Lord. He'll work it out.
Yes, amen.
Just submit yourself unto God. Just like Jesus came down and submitted Himself unto all mankind.
Yes, amen.
To die on the cross that we might have the right to the fruit of life.
Thank you, Lord.
That we can give Him the praise, the honor, and the glory. Because He's worthy of all things. Without Him, we can't make it. But through Him, all things is possible.
Yes,
hallelujah to Jesus. That's the reason why I remember Jesus was born of a virgin.
Yes, amen.
And she was foretold ahead of time. Just like us, God tells us things ahead of time, and instead of us, a lot of times, listening to Him, we do it just the opposite. And when it does just the opposite, it don't work right. Yeah. But if we do what the Lord tells us to do, it'll come out right. And everything works according to God's will and His way. Not our will and way, but His will and His way. Even in our families, God can do it, and He will do it right. We think we can, but we can't. But God can. God can. So let us, as children of God, believe in Him, depend on Him, walk by grace with Him. Because through grace, we are saved. His grace, His mercy, His love, and His kindness has drawn us unto Him. And so we have to depend on the Lord all day long. As long as we live, we depend on God. Because He's going to be there when nobody else will. He's going to walk with you when nobody else will. He'll talk to you when nobody else will. So let us depend on God, because He has all power in His hands. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come and walk with me.
Well, who are you?
Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. While I live on this
Walk with me, Lord, walk with me.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. Said you had something to say to.
Yeah, I got a few words to say.
Put on the mic.
I was.
Give him the mic, please.
I was reading a story.
Pastor.
It's a true story. And this happened a couple thousand years ago. It was a group of men that loved God dearly. And they wanted to serve him really dearly, but then they lost him. He died. And so they didn't know what to do. They didn't know what to do. So they said, one day they said, well, I'm all depressed. Let's go fishing. Maybe we can catch us something to eat at least. So they went fishing. And they fished all night. Didn't catch nothing. But the next morning, Jesus was standing on the shore. And I love what he said. He said, cast your net on the other side.
All right.
Cast your net. And they got plenty of fish. But what I was trying to say here is, when I came in today, I noticed some of the people didn't, maybe one or two, you know, of you did not feel very good. Maybe, you know, maybe you had a broken heart, or maybe you was depressed a little bit or something. But what Jesus is saying is, cast your net on the other side. And he said, I will be with you forever and ever. So that's what I wanted to tell you this morning. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. And I absolutely love the message the pastor preached today. It's absolutely great. Wasn't it great? Thank you. You're a great man. You're a great preacher.
Praise God. Nobody but the Lord. It's not me, but the Lord that lives with
you. Yes, thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Praise God. Alrighty. We're going to stand for prayer and dismissal. And while we're at this, we're going to pray for the sick also. Hallelujah, Jesus. Lord God of grace, Lord Jesus, we come before you, Lord, to give you the praise, the honor, and the glory, Lord. We come before you, Lord Jesus, to magnify your name, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon Chris, Lord Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, the pastor's brother's friend, Lord, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to touch his body, Lord Jesus, with your power from on high, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon Grandma Mary Lou's daughter, Lord Jesus, that are in our presence, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to touch her body, Lord, from the crown of her head to the sole of her feet, Lord Jesus, with your healing virtue, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, we know, Lord Jesus, that you have all power in your hand, Lord Jesus. Your healing power, your saving, and your keeping power, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to look upon, Lord Jesus, every sick person, Lord Jesus, throughout the nation, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to touch their bodies, Lord, with your healing virtue, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, for we know, Lord, that you have all power in your hand, Lord Jesus. Through you, by you, Lord Jesus, all things is possible, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord God of hosts, Lord Jesus, as we depart from this place, Lord Jesus, but not from your presence, Lord, we ask you, Lord Jesus, to take us to our destination, safe, sound, without any hurt, harm, or danger, Lord. We ask you, Lord Jesus, to bring us back on due time, Lord. These blessings and others we ask in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Praise the Lord.